All right, what's happening? Manchester Derby weekend. It's at Old Trafford. Saturday, 5:30 kickoff. Manchester United vs Manchester City. Will this be the end of Ole Gunnar Solskjaer? Will Pep outclass him, or will it be the opposite and Pep get absolutely done? Both clubs come into this off of a back of a polar opposite European week. Manchester United went to RB Leipzig just needing a point to qualify. They ultimately lost 3-2 and are down to the Europa League. Well, the opposite for Manchester City, they have qualified for the last 16. After 3-0 win against Marseille, they qualified 2 weeks ago. They both won in the last Premier League outing. Manchester United are away to West Ham. They beat them 3-1 after going 1-0 down to West Ham to pull back to 3-1. Manchester United won. Manchester City, on the other hand, simple win against Fulham. Just a minute till his car go pies. While Man City beat Fulham 2-0 at the Etihad, very comfortable victory for Pep Guardiola's team. They both clubs sit respectively 6th and 7th in the Premier League table, with a win for either club will put them within touching distance of top of the league. Both will go into the Champions League positions. While it's very hard to call, this derby will be one that is probably closer than what it was last season, with City being second and United not being exactly the best. This will be a bit more of an interesting derby, as they're fairly similarly matched, with results with kind of league positions, obviously. It'll be definitely a good watch Saturday night at Old Trafford. Who do I think wins? I think it's going to be a 2-1 Manchester United win. I feel the way that City have struggled in recent times at coming to Old Trafford and playing away from home against the big teams, as this season they have lost to Liverpool. No, they don't. They've lost to Tottenham away and so on. Their away form for Man City, has they been the best? Man United's home form, has they been the best? But in the derby, you never know. One goal can change the whole complexity of the game. Could easily be going Pep's way. City could easily be dominating. And then a simple goal from United could end up seeing an absolute slaughtering against them. It can go either way. I'm saying 2-1 Manchester United. Now we'll move on to match 2. Everton vs Chelsea at Goodison Park, 8 o'clock kickoff. Everton sit just aside the European places after drawing 1 each last weekend to Burnley, while Chelsea sit 3rd, 2 points off top of the league after a 3-1 win against Leeds United last weekend, after going 1-0 down. Both teams are same as the both Manchester clubs, evenly matched, both very good in attack, both can be very good defensively, but can also be very poor defensively. Both is more setting up to a Chelsea win here. Under Ancelotti, they have been at the strong point that they were within the first 4 or 5 games. But ultimately, a simple win for Everton under Ancelotti is very much possible, as we all know. For this game, it's going to be how the teams line up. If Frank Lampard puts in Kepa, or does he trust Edouard Mendy as he has been since he's signed? Goes with Mendy, he wins the game. Goes with Kepa, he loses the game. It's just a simple choice of goalkeepers. It's going to be extremely hard to tell. For me personally, I'm going to say a 3-1 Chelsea here. Even though Everton are very, very strong, it is a difference of the defence and the goalkeeper. As we know that Chelsea can be very poor, as they were last season defensively. They have strengthened this season, but at the same time, Everton have got extremely much more stronger. You've seen them add to their midfield and attack, not at all to the defence, so that can be the deciding factor. But it's all about what we see happens. I'm saying 3-1 Chelsea, saying that Frank Lampard gets another one over Everton. And with that, we'll move on to match day 3, which is Wolves versus Aston Villa at the Molineux Stadium. Both teams are sitting mid-table, respectively, after a very good start for both teams in the season. They've both kind of dropped off now. Aston Villa haven't played for 2 weeks. The last game was away against West Ham, which they lost 2-1. But also Wolves' last game, they lost 4-0 away against Liverpool. So both teams are off the back of a loss. But both teams are fairly well poised to ultimately make it a very interesting game. All 3 games this weekend, the Derby in Manchester, Everton Chelsea, and now Wolves Aston Villa, they're all similar games, all similar teams to each other. But this game is gonna be more of who turns up on the day. As we know with Wolves and Aston Villa, both teams very well on the day, but they're not performing well enough constantly. Wolves at the back end of last season were doing okay, while Villa was scrapping for their lives in the Premier League. This season, Aston Villa have added a new dimension to the team. As we know, they started off well, they went top of the league for a bit, but now they've tailed off direct into mid-table. But they've definitely got a better team now than they did last season, 100%. For me, I'm going to see this go to a Wolves 2-0 win. I can see Aston Villa yet again coming unstuck. It's not really going to be a game with the likes of Jack Grealish, Ollie Watkins, Trezeguet and all that. If Aston Villa get really much of a chance to get their creative ability. But on the other hand, as we know, all it takes is one chance and Ollie Watkins will score. He just needs that one chance and he will bury it. Jack Grealish is a very creative midfielder, which can help Aston Villa out. As he drops into numerous positions, he'll be a striker 1 minute, attacking, then he'll be back defending at right back 10 seconds later. But I don't see this going any other way than a Wolves win. 2-0 for Wolves. The Everton Chelsea game, I'm saying 3-1 Chelsea. Manchester Derby, I'm saying 2-1 Manchester United. With that, I've talked enough on today's episode. With that, if you've enjoyed it, leave a like, helps the channel, subscribe to the channel. There's a link in the description for Future Colours official Twitter account to get your very own in real life FIFA Ultra Team cards. For 25% off plus free shipping, use our link, say we sent you, and you'll receive that. There's also a link in the description for the official Twitter account for the channel. If you want to drop us a follow, that would be very much appreciated. Hope you've enjoyed the week. It's been a simply decent week. With more football at the weekend, it's going to be quite enjoyable. Hope you all have a good weekend. I'll see you all for Monday's episode. With that, enjoy the weekend. Goodbye.